Hey you guys, welcome back to the channel Physics Sergi, and this is JE Advanced Solutions series, and we are into 2016 paper. And as you could see on the screen, the so-called toughest JE Advanced question on rotation, okay, so ever is what people say, internet says that. So we'll try to investigate whether that particular claim is true or not, whether this is a problem, nightmare, or a cult classic. We'll try to explore into this particular problem. We have been building up to this particular question through a precursor. I have already posted a rolling cone problem from Irado 1.57, where you are given certain concepts, and in case you have not watched that video, I would urge you to go back and watch that particular video. Okay, so interestingly, for this particular question, not only the question or the problem was considered to be very highly debated one, but also the key given by JE, final key, contained double key. That means they gave B or BD kind of a key. So we'll try to also investigate why JE has done that, whether they have done the right thing or not. Okay, so let me move forward. I'm very much excited. So I would request, in case you are on your mobile phone, I would request this video at least deserves your complete attention and also full screen. So please do watch it in landscape and full screen so that you get the entire concepts that we are going to discuss through. And it's going to be slightly longer video. And so make sure that you have enough time to last till the end of the video. One thing's for sure, whether you understand the concept before or not, but by the end of this video, the nitty-gritties of this particular topic would be so well nuanced that you would feel better in this topic of angular momentum and rotational mechanics at the end of this video. That's a definite outcome that you'll get from this particular video. So let's move ahead. This is the formal wording. In case you are a person who has nothing to do with JE and you're just watching this particular problem, and you're a physics lover and especially rotational mechanics, I would urge you to just pause the video here, try to go through this question, enjoy this question, and have a roller coaster ride, right? So for maybe 20-30 minutes, you try this question, I'm pretty sure you would require at least 20 minutes of worth of your time. Okay, so for those who have already gone through this question, there is a two circular discs of mass m and 4m. As you could see, they are connected by a light rigid rod of length l. The value of l is given in terms of this radius. This assembly is laid on firm flat surface and set rolling without slipping, very important, on the surface, so that the angular speed about the axis of the rod is omega. Okay, about the axis of, that means spin angular momentum is omega. The angular momentum of the entire assembly about point O is L bar. Okay, so which of the following statements, these are true? So more than one might be correct. Okay, so there are options. Each and every option is a concept in its own. Okay, so first one talks about center of mass of the assembly about Z axis. Okay, right. He's talking about orbital angular velocity, as we call it, orbital angular velocity. Then magnitude of angular momentum of center of mass about point O. So L of CM about point O. Then magnitude of angular momentum of assembly about its center of mass. That means L about CM, he's asking. D, magnitude of Z component of this L bar that he discussed in the question is the fourth option. Okay, so let's first of all dive into the concepts that are required to solve this problem. Okay, so I'll go through them very quickly, right? And I urge you, once the video is over, you come back and try to see them in a slow manner. And in case you are a JE aspirant, I would request you to take down notes of this particular problem. Okay, so LO, which is the angular momentum about O, right? For example, I have taken a simplistic situation where there is a rod and it's rotating in a conical pendulum manner about this blue axis. Can you see that? And in that rotation, we would say that the angular momentum of this rod about this suspension point O would be perpendicular to the rod like this. As this rod moves and completes its rotations, even this angular momentum vector would complete its conical rotations. Okay, and in this problem, angular velocity of this particular rod would be in the Z direction or the axis direction. You could clearly see about the axis, if the mass distribution is not symmetric, you can claim that this orbital, the angular momentum about point O will not point in the direction of omega. So they are not parallel in asymmetric distribution of mass about axis. By chance, if you had a V-shaped rod instead of just one rod, where now you could see the rod has uniform distribution on both sides of the axis. That means there is a symmetry. Okay. So in this case, when you rotate, the angular momentum about point O would be in the same direction as omega. So symmetry and asymmetry, you should keep it in mind. And this particular problem of JE Advanced falls in the asymmetric context. This is the first point. Second important point is you are advised, actually this is a common misconception that goes around, is that a lot of people put that omega also in this direction. So something like this, which is not advised to be used in the above motion, right? So it goes against this principle that we need to understand that L and omega are not parallel, at least taken about point, and omega is taken always about axis in this scenario. Imagine someone actually draws this, then you should tell them that you are actually not considering the conical motion. Instead, if L is like this and omega is like this, this rod during the next period will actually go in a circular motion in this plane. Can you feel that? When someone curls his fingers along this circular motion, then he should say the omega in this is in this particular direction. Okay, then it will become a planar motion. So in a general planar motion, L and omega are always parallel. In a general planar motion, L and omega will be always parallel. But this is not a general planar motion. Okay, so this is something that you need to keep in mind. And people who want to refresh this idea of L being parallel, not being parallel, why this is different from this situation, please do refer to Resnick, Halliday and Crane book section 10.3. It's beautifully explained with nice diagrams, and that will be enriching for you people. Okay, next, let's move on to the third important point. We always discuss that L about a point P for a system of particles is always L of CM about P plus L about CM. This is a standard result that we'll keep using. It's a theorem, we can prove that, okay? And CM is always a translatory frame. This is something that you need to keep in mind. CM is a point, and in rotational mechanics, points don't rotate. It's a conceptual point. So when you sit on that point, all the translatory motion gets canceled and you see only rotatory motion from CM frame. So I repeat, CM is always a translatory frame, okay? Right, next. Fourth important thing is the discussion of the instantaneous axis of rotation. So the video will become longer if I discuss it here. So I've already made a precursor video of rolling cone, which is the IRIDO 1.57 problem solution with more concepts explained. So the link of that video is in the description below. So those who are new to this channel and not watched it, I would request you to watch that video and then further continue. Okay, right. So let's move on. Now we'll come back to the JE Advanced question, where I have taken the two discs, as you could see, and this is the floor on which it is rolling around like this in this scenario. And even though he said it is omega, to be very, very clear in our solution, I have put a subscript omega S. Okay, omega S. So in that precursor video of IRIDO, we have already seen that this particular motion where body goes around like this and also spins around itself can be seen to be due to two omegas. Okay, one called as omega S, which is the spin angular velocity, whose direction, if you curl your right-handed fingers like this, the thumb will point in this direction. So can you see this is the direction of omega spin? Okay, right. And the orbital angular velocity, where the object goes around like this, remember this is going around like this and it's an asymmetric axis distribution. Omega will O stands for not omega about point O, it is the orbital angular velocity. So that omega orbital motion would be this, spin motion is this, and net omega, right, would be considered as the superposition of these two, right? What is the direction of net omega? You recollect that this is the point of no slipping, and this is also point of no slipping, which means these two points are at rest on this rigid system. So line joining them should be instantaneous axis of rotation. And I've already proved in that rolling cone problem that the net omega, which is the superposition of this and this orbital angular velocity and spin angular velocity, should always lie along the IAR. So I'm denoting net omega with this capital omega symbol. As you could see, I have vectorially added omega naught and omega s and making it omega bar. Okay, what does that lead to? Remember, out of these three, omega s was given in the question. He called it omega. I have written it as omega s. And this angle theta can be easily found out in this right angle triangle using sine theta equal to 1 by 5. You can clearly see this. Then you would say if white and green should result in this capital omega, then capital omega should be simply omega s cos theta. Okay, so that's what I have written. So the net omega I have already known. Okay, then what should be this omega naught? It should cancel out the other component of omega s, which is omega s sin theta. That's what I have written. So the value of orbital angular velocity around that z axis that this object rotates would be simply omega s by phi. I think this was one of the options that was given. He has asked, if you go back to the actual question, you could see the first one, center of mass of the assembly rotates about the z axis with an angular velocity of omega by phi. That is the orbital angular velocity. As you could see, I'm showing it in the screen. Okay, right. So that problem has been solved. One option is done away with. Let's move on. Now we have to analyze angular momentum about center of mass, right? This was a very tricky one. This is where the double key came from the IIT. Okay, so let's try to, I have borrowed the diagram all over again. You have already seen that IAR is this, and the white direction is the direction of omega s, which is the spin. Okay, and that spin angular velocity also results in an angular momentum in the direction of that. So LS represents the spin angular momentum of this particular system. Apart from that, of center of mass, you should realize there is a velocity of center of mass which would be going into the plane as it, as this one turns around, right? Velocity of center of mass would be going into the plane or out of the plane, it depends. And due to that, there will be an LO. Remember in the first discussion we had, when the system is not symmetric about axis in its mass distribution, the LO and omega O need not coincide with each other. So it would be wrong to put LO this way, and it will be wrong to put omega O in this direction. That you need to be very, very careful with. Now, let's try to, out of all these things, I think LS is the easiest to calculate because it's like a pure rotation. Can you see? LS is like having an axis like this, and object is just spinning around that axis. And for a pure rotation, LS is I into omega, where I is the moment of inertia about this white axis. I have calculated that from the given information. I get 17 ma square by 2, and 17 ma square by 2 omega s would be the value of angular momentum, spin angular momentum. Please don't call it angular momentum about CM yet. Okay, so you need to understand that this is the spin angular momentum. This was one of the options, but is it angular momentum about center of mass? Let's go further. Okay, now LS represents, right, angular momentum of the assembly about CM if the CM frame is already rotating with omega O. That means when someone sits on the CM frame and goes around, you should understand that fellow is a translating frame. He will be experiencing both the omegas actually. He will be experiencing both. Calling the CM frame and saying that he will only experience omega S is a wrong notion. Okay, right? So let me try to put more thought into it. Right, but L about CM will be able to, will be due to both omega naught and omega s. If someone says that L about CM is only spin angular momentum, then he's discounting the omega naught's contribution about that center of mass axis. Okay, so the answer would be greater than LS. Okay, so 17 ma square by 2 omega s is a wrong option. I'll come to that why IIT gave that answer also. Okay, right. Now, so to drive my point better of how different is a translational frame and rotational frame when you sit on a center of mass, okay, I've taken a much simpler situation of a rod pivoted about its end and rotating with an angular velocity. I think this is a very familiar situation. And imagine I wait for some time, the rod's position has turned by an angle theta. Now I have placed a person at center of mass, he's an observer, okay, right? And this observer can be either translating observer, okay, or translating frame of reference, or a rotating frame of reference attached to this particular rod. Now just watch, his eye is having a line of sight towards B. He's just concentrating towards the end B. Now, if that fellow is a translating frame of reference, right, his eye will always move, or not move, I should say his eyes will always point in the rightward direction. His head won't rotate. If he's watching something like this here, he'll continue to watch in that direction. That's what translation means. Heads don't rotate. They just move in a circle path, but head won't rotate. So for this fellow, you ask him that he's watching in this direction, he would have said B has actually rotated by same angle theta as the entire rod has rotated. So he would say, according to this guy, the entire rod is having a pure rotation of angular velocity omega. Actually, this is how the center of mass frame should be taken. The center of mass is a point, and points don't rotate, and it's always a translating frame. Whereas if someone argues, okay, I am talking about a frame attached to center of mass and it's a rotating frame, then this fellow's eyes and his line of sight also rotates by the time he comes to this position. This is a case two or an assumption two. In this scenario, he would say, B is in front of me right from the start. Even now, B is in front of me. So according to this guy, observer will feel that B, and not just B, every point on the rod is at rest. So if you are attaching center of mass to a rotating frame, then entire system will be seen to be at rest. Okay. So the idea is, in the previous problem, you have attaching the center of mass, you should take the translatory frame, and both the omegas, whatever you have seen in the previous problem, should be considered in your calculation. Right? So otherwise, what happens is, if you don't take translating frame, this formula of ours would not be correct. We are always taught angular momentum of a system is L of CM plus L about CM. In of CM, you calculate the translatory motion, and about CM should be this. Right? If about CM is this, then you'll always get about CM answer to be a zero value. Okay, so there's no point actually calculating this. So I repeat, it's a center of mass frame, if not considered or mentioned, should always be translating frame. Okay, so in translating frame, the person will feel that the rod is purely rotating about himself. Okay, right. Next. So the fact is, by definition, CM is a point and points don't rotate, and CM frame is a translating frame by definition. Okay, so about CM, how does it feel like now after all this discussion? So I've drawn back that system. Now, only this dotted line you consider, right? Just don't consider all this. Just watch this. Okay, if a CM guy whose eyes were the same as the translating frame in the previous problem were to sit here and his head is not rotating, then he would see both omega naught. I borrowed this omega naught and placed it here for him, and omega spin. Both these numbers or both these vectors would be felt by this fellow. So about CM, both omega naught and omega s should be considered, and writing the angular momentum only as this I into omega s is wrong. Okay, so in that case, the answer would be more than that 17 by 2 ma square omega s. Then why did IIT actually give an answer which was this option with C option they have given? So those who have marked C, they have actually given it correct, and those who have not marked, who are more correct, I would say, also they received the full credit. Okay, the reason is because this particular situation, it's slightly beyond JEE advanced syllabus, you would say, that where you are talking about two different omegas, right? So we generally talk about a fixed axis rotation or omega about only one axis. So maybe JEE has felt that in that particular scenario, it is too much to ask from a students to actually ascertain whether this is right or not. So they wanted to reward the people who considered angular momentum about center of mass as only the spin angular momentum, and those who actually did it correctly the way I am discussing, they also wanted to reward these people. So but if you want to be very hard on people and consider, then this is a wrong option for sure. C is wrong. Answer should be more than that. This covers only spin, whereas about center of mass, you'll get that omega O term also added vectorially. Okay, right. So next one. So we are done with that option. And next. So LZ investigation, the last one that we are going to talk about, is the angular momentum about Z axis. So now we realize that there is an orbital angular momentum, right, about, or angular momentum of center of mass about this particular point, which is LO, and also the spin that would be there in this particular direction. Okay, so I need to calculate what is the component of this LO and LS contribution in Z direction. Both will contribute. You should realize one very important thing. Omega O and omega S will result in an omega along IAR. That's for sure. But there is no rule that LO and LS would result in this particular direction. Remember, L net and Omega net again need not be parallel to each other, because about IAR, this is not a uniform mass distribution. You don't see this object on the other side of IAR. Okay, so it would be surprising if I have LO and LS only contributing in Z direction. Okay, so that is another important thing that you need to take it for the future concept. Okay, so my job therefore is to find first of all LO. LO is simply velocity of center of mass, m into vcm into this r that I have to calculate. Okay, I think this r is simply, this is l plus this would be 4l by 5 using the center of mass location. Okay, so I did that. So this distance of cm up from O is 9l by 5. Okay, now you know from the concept of IAR, the velocity of center of mass can be directly written as dropping a perpendicular onto IAR, marking this as some z distance, multiplied by net omega. Remember this net capital omega, yellow color. So I've written VCM as Z into omega. Z I know is 9L by 5 sine theta. Can you see this big triangle? And omega is already in the first page. We found out from omega S as root 24 by 5 omega S. You can go back to that particular page and then check how we found this one. Okay. So VCM is known. We are ready for mass into VCM into the distance to calculate LO, remember that. Okay, so omega O is orbital angular velocity of the body, and notice these two are not parallel. I kept on telling you, okay, these two need not be parallel to each other. So the value of LO is 5m, because total mass I have to take, multiplied by VCM and multiplied by 9L by 5. With all those numbers substituted carefully, that VCM I borrow from here to this place, then 9L by 5, L is root 24A, and lot of calculation later, you'd end up having the answer. I wrote it in this manner. Okay. And he has given the value of LO in one of the options as 81 MA square omega S. 81 MA square. So this extra term, which is slightly less than one, makes that answer wrong. Okay. So this one I'm talking about. Magnitude of angular momentum of center of mass of assembly about 0.0, which I marked as LO. Remember, it should be in this direction. Okay, in this direction. Answer is not 81, but 81 into root 24 by 5. Okay, so that would be the correct answer for that. Okay, now LZ. LZ is, as I told you, both LO and LS will contribute. Okay, so let me show you the diagram very clearly in the screen. Okay, so LO's component this direction. See, I've drawn it here. With this green line, it will make an angle theta again, right? So LO cos theta and LS sine theta would be in this direction. Okay, so as this body turns around, LO will have its own conical motion like this, and LS will also have its own conical motion. Very complicated, but very beautiful if you can visualize that. Okay, so I subtracted. I already know all these values from the previous options. Only difficulty is the calculation during the exam. So I substituted these numbers, cos thetas, LS values, rearranged. I'll get something which is rational number. All the root 24s get cancelled, and I end up getting something like 76 point something MA square omega S, whereas the answer in the option D that he was mentioning is 55. So this is definitely not the answer. So going by what I consider it as correct answer, only A is the correct answer, whereas C is given as a leeway, I could say, as a kind of you'd say forgiveness for attempting this particular question. Okay, so strictly speaking, this is not right, and this is only spin angular momentum. I repeat, angular momentum about center of mass in this problem will have both the components of the spin value and the orbital value. Okay, so the final given key, that's why for this particular options, was given as A, which is absolutely right, or A comma C. So this was a kind of a leeway they mentioned in the paper. Okay, so for those students who have attempted this question in the exam, it's hats off, because there's a lot of calculations involved and a lot of patience you require in your calculations. And for attempting for 4 marks this kind of a question in an exam, it's very, very difficult. And for us, it is actually a kind of a bonus, because you get to learn a lot of things that are generally not part of our NCERT textbook. Okay, so you should see this, that's why, as a cult classic, and it's a favorite among a lot of students and professors who value rotation chapter a lot. I hope you have actually enjoyed the way this was done. So just wait for this. What is our next video? You would be really stoked to see. Actually, 2016 was a bonanza year for rotation. Okay, so much before 2016's JEE Advanced paper, there was a paper on JEE Mains offline that happened 1 month before, actually, in which there was another beautiful and debated rotational motion question. Not as tough as this, it's more theoretical. And for people who have been following my videos of rolling cone and the present one, JEE Advanced one that I have done, this would be a cakewalk, but it would be a nice way to round off all the effort we have put in by taking up this JEE Mains debated question series, in which we are going to take up this 2016 offline question. I will not spoil your experience by reading it right now. So please do read this and I'll come up with a solution at a shortest way possible and a very insightful way in solving this, where all the effort we have put in will be fruitful right now. Okay, so I hope you have liked all this, the way we have connected all the questions. So there are other important series going on in this channel. As you could see on the screen, all these series playlists have been curated and the links of these are in the description below. And I hope for the effort we have put in the last 1 week, I think we should get a like for this particular video. Share it across people. I have seen a lot of people come up with wrong and misconceived solutions. So it's time actually we correct them. And in case you have your own opinions about the solution, please do post it in the comments. I would be very happy to reply to them. And please do subscribe to my channel as we go forward in spreading physics. Okay. Thank you. Take care and see you in the next video.